This video outlines the process I went through to create a video with a customized VFX in a FreeCAD animation. The created video is a conceptual representation of a metal powder producing process for use in 3D printers, etc. The softwares utilized here are all free. The created videos are shown. Two metal wires are continuously fed into both sides of a chamber, filled with the inert gas. When an electrical voltage is applied between the two wires, an arc is generated, melting the metal. A gas nozzle is placed below where the molten metal is falling and sprayed. While falling down, it cools to form a solid powder. This is the view of the fully assembled equipment in FreeCAD. The VFX is applied to half-cut view for the inside to be seen. This is the FreeCAD animations before adding VFX. Driving of the bobbins, guide rollers, feeder rollers and wires was done in the assembly 4 workbench. Based on the rotation speed of the bobbin, the rotation or linear speed of each part depends. I captured 3 still images of the moment when the distance between the two ends of the wires becomes close enough to generate the arc, front view, bird eye view, and near bird eye view. These images were used as the backgrounds when creating the particle VFX. Now in this video, I explain the case of the front view as an example only. To create the particle VFX, I utilize the Particle Illusion Standalone Software, PIS. Opening PIS, I loaded the basic emitter at first, selected the single particle in the properties, changed the shape image by importing the captured front view image. And set the size to 1440 considering the resolution of the captured image. It didn't have to be exactly this size, I could adjust it later in DaVinci Resolve. The Atom Rays 02 emitter was used to represent the appearance of the arc. 3 elements among the 7 elements, glow, lines, and lines 2 were used. I roughly adjusted some characteristics such as position, size, and color to match the imported background image. The falling molten metal was represented using the Anime Jet Engine emitter and Torch 02 emitter. In the Anime Jet Engine, the angle in addition to the position, size, and color was adjusted. In the Torch 02 flame element, the shape image was changed additionally. I then went through the 3 emitters I've used so far and adjusted their characteristics while looking at their overall balance. To arrange each emitter to appear sequentially from the top, I adjusted the time intervals for which the size of each emitter changes from 0 to full size. For the molten metal being sprayed, the water sprinkler emitter was utilized. I adjusted the emission angle, emission range, number and position, and change the shape from the line to the point. I tried the color of the particles to be changed gradually from red to yellow during falling down as it cools, but it wasn't appeared as well as I wanted. I also adjusted the time interval for the particle to reach the full size. Later, after adding this VFX to the FreeCAD animation, I revised some characteristics of these emitters to improve the general appearance. Since the particles being sprayed ignore the boundary of the cooling tank, I added several deflectors to guide them to go through the bottom conduit. Even with the deflectors, it was not possible to guide them completely into the conduit, so I decided to use a mask while editing in the next DaVinci Resolve stage. The final task in PIS was rendering. I turned the top background image off, so that it is not visible, and then ran render to create a particle effect video. For adding VFX to FreeCAD animation, I utilized DaVinci Resolve. First, the captured image of the FreeCAD front view and the VXF created in PIS were loaded into the V1 V2 track, and the duration of the captured image was adjusted to be longer than the VFX. In the Fusion tab, I connected the VFX as the foreground and the captured image as the background to Media Out 1 and applied a mask to remove the particles scattering outside of the cooling chamber. Then, I deleted the captured image and connected the VFX with the mask directly to Media Out 1. Going to the Edit tab, I adjusted the size of the VFX and removed the captured image on the V1 track. I loaded the animation video created in FreeCAD into the V1 track and removed its audio clip. As the movement of wire feeding device in the recorded animation was too slow, I increased the speed by using the Retime Controls and Retime Curve tools. And then, I adjusted the VFX timing on the V2 track to be triggered at the time when the ends of the two wires reach the position where the arc occurs. I removed the leftover FreeCAD animation video and adjusted the VFX position slightly. Rendering was done in the Deliver tab. Thank you for watching.